In this section, we will discuss lecture 4th of class 10th. This is lecture 4th of class 10th, current electricity. In this lecture, we are going to discuss resistance of a conductor. We know from Ohm's law, which I have already discussed, V is equal to IR, where V is our potential, V was our potential difference, I was current over there. And R is resistance. We are going to define this term, that is resistance. Now over there, if I derive expression for R, then R will be equal to V by I. But I have already explained it there that R does not change with the value of potential. It does not change with the value of the current. You can check that video and see why R does not depend upon potential and current. Now see, unit of potential is volt, SI unit. And current is ampere, therefore SI unit of resistance becomes ohm. Volt per ampere is called ohm, or we represent it by omega. Now see, when our resistance will be 1 ohm, 1 ohm resistance, we will define over here 1 ohm resistance, 1 ohm resistance. Now under what conditions we can have 1 ohm resistance? Now if potential applied across a conductor is 1 volt and it produces a current of 1 ampere, then resistance is said to be 1 ohm. If we have 1 volt potential and current produced in the circuit is 1 ampere, then resistance is said to be 1 ohm. Now see, on what factors now this resistance actually depends? If we have a conductor, now let us take a conductor, this is conductor. Let us take a conductor, let L be the length of the conductor and A be the area of cross section of a conductor. This is area of cross section of a conductor. Now see, resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. The greater the length of a conductor, greater is resistance, and it is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Greater the area of cross section, smaller is resistance. Now combining this equation and this equation, equation first and equation second, we get R is directly proportional to L by A. If we eliminate this proportionality, we use a constant, R is equal to rho into L by A. New term comes over here, that is rho, where this R is our resistance, L is the length of a conductor, A is the area of cross section of a conductor. Area of cross section of a conductor, and this rho, it's called a resistivity. This resistivity, it is represented by a rho. This resistivity, it depends upon only nature of the metal, nature of the conductor, and it depends upon temperature. It's a function of temperature. It will not depend upon length and area of cross section. Now we get our expression, R is equal to rho into L by A. R is equal to rho into L by A. This is our required expression. R is equal to rho into L by A. Resistance is equal to resistivity. This is called resistivity into length divided by area of cross section. Now let us do questions on this. Let us consider a resistor. This is our resistor. This is our conductor, sorry, let us consider a conductor. Let the length of the conductor is 6 meters or centimeters. And let the area of the cross section of the conductor, this is area of cross section, let it is 2 centimeters square. Area is equal to length into breadth, that's why centimeter into centimeter, that is centimeter square, 2 centimeters square. We have to determine it is resistivity. If rho is given, rho for this conductor, if it is given, it is 3. If rho is given, it is 3. What is the unit of rho? Let us derive the unit of rho. This rho will be equal to, if I bring this A over here, it will be equal to R into A by L. Since rho depends, does not depend upon area and length, it only depends upon rho is equal to R into A by L. This rho is called specific resistance. R it is called resistivity. It depends only upon nature of metal. nature of conductor and it depends upon temperature. This is very important. It depends upon temperature. Resistivity depends upon nature of conductor and it depends upon nature of metal. Now what will be the unit of this rho? See, unit of R is ohm, unit of area is centimeter square and unit of length is centimeter. Therefore, it is ohm centimeter. This will be the unit. Now see, R is equal to rho into L by A. We are given length is equal to 6, rho is equal to 3. Length is equal to 6, area is equal to 2. 2 3s are 6, therefore resistance is 9 ohms. Now one more question we will discuss over here. We know that resistance is equal to rho into L by A. If we have two conductors, this is conductor 1 and this is conductor 2. This is conductor 2. Conductor 1, its length is L1 and its length is L2. Its area of cross section is A2. Its area of cross section is A1. What will be resistance for this conductor? It will be R1. What will be for this conductor? It will be R2. R1 will be equal to rho into L1 by A1. I have not changed rho because I treat both of these are made up of same metal. For example, this is made up of copper metal. This is also made up of copper metal. Therefore, resistivity will be same because it depends upon nature of the metal. Similarly, R2 will be equal to rho will be same into length of this is L2 and area of cross section of this is A2. This is equation first, this is equation second. If I divide equation first and equation second, this and this will get cancelled. I will get R1 divided by R2 is equal to L1 by A1 divided by L2 by A2. Or further simplifying it, L1 by A1, this will get inverted, that's A2 by L2. This becomes new formula for us. What is this new formula? We can solve questions from this formula. R1 by R2 is equal to L1 by L2 into A2 by A1. This becomes new formula. Let us solve a question based on this formula. Now we are given two conductors of copper metal having length 3 omega and 5 omega respectively means first one will be having 3 omega and the second one 5 omega and area of cross section 5 ohm per centimeter and 3 ohm per centimeter respectively. Now we have to determine their ratio of resistances. Now what we are given? We are given resistance R1. It is equal to rho into L1 by A1. This is our formula. And we are given resistance R2 will be equal to rho into L2 by A2. Now see, in the first case, length 3 centimeters and 5 centimeters. Sorry, I wrongly quoted it. Now see, our length L1 is given 3 centimeters. In this case, L1 is given 3 centimeters. L2 is given 5 centimeters. And area of cross section is respectively, this is for first, this is for second. Well, respectively tells us this is for first, this is for second. A1 is equal to 5, A2 is equal to 3. Now substitute the values, R1 by R2, R1 by R2 is equal to L1 by L2 into A2 by A1. Now what is L1 over here? It is 3. What is L2? It is 5. Therefore it is 3 by 5. What is A2? It is 3. What is A1? It is 5. Therefore it becomes 9 by 25. This is our ratio of R1 by R2. This is our ratio of R1 by R2. These are the questions how you have to solve questions. Let us take one more question. Let us take one more question. You are considering a wire of length L and area of cross section A. This is the experiment number first. Now you carry the same experiment by folding this wire. ये आपके पास wire है, इसकी length L है और इसका area of cross section A है. Now in the next experiment, what you are doing? You are folding it. I'll fold this wire like this. Now I'll fold this wire. In the second experiment, I'll fold this wire. When I'll fold the wire, this part will come over this part. Now this was first wire. Its length was L and area of cross section was A. Now what I did? I folded this wire. Now after folding, what happens? This was the length. Now the length gets reduced. How much it gets reduced? It gets reduced to half. Now the new length becomes L by 2. What happens to the area of cross section? This was area of cross section. Now the area of cross section gets doubled. This is area of cross section. A becomes 2A. A becomes 2A. Now this is length L. This is A. In the next experiment, experiment number 2, what happens? I had folded this conductor. After folding, length reduces to half. If I fold it 2 times, it becomes half. If I fold it 3 times, it becomes L by 3. If I fold it 4 times, it becomes L by 4. For example, if I fold it like this 1 times, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, this is L. After folding 2 times, L by 2, L by 3, L by 4, L by 5. Now see what we have to determine. We have to determine ratio of resistance R1 and ratio of resistance R2. Now we have expressed a general formula. R1 by R2 is equal to L1 by L2 into A2 by A1. Now tell me, what's in this case L1? It's L. What's in this case A1? It is A. Now therefore R1 by R2 in first experiment length is L. In second experiment it is L by 2. In first and into A2. A2 means area of cross section of second. In second experiment area is 2A. And in first experiment area is A. Now A and A will go. This 2 will come over here. This will be 2 into 2. That is 4. That is 4. R1 by R2 is equal to 4. R1 is equal to 4 times R2. Now this is how questions can be solved on based upon resistance. In the next lecture we will do combination of resistance, series combination and parallel combination of resistance, and we will solve numerical problems over there as well. Now this is all about this resistance. Thanks for watching.